Thank you. all thanks to the Wagner Society of New York. I'd like to give them a round of applause for hosting me today. This would not have happened without their support this past year in their competition and their grant, which has helped me embark on this wonderful journey to start my young Wagnerian career in growing in this epic music. It has brought me so many new wonderful adventures, and this wouldn't be possible, of course, without Scott. I know Scott somewhere here. Yeah, Scott. And David, and all my coaches, and I have to say a special thanks to, of course, Mitchell Serker, who got me in touch with the wonderful Wagner Society. He's not here today, but I hope he's looking at the live stream. And as well as my coach, Hugh Cronon, and my teacher, Jennifer Rowley, and of course, my mother, my father, and my sister, who have supported me along this journey, and all my friends and loved ones who have taken care of me to get here. So, without final anything else. Oh, and hey, and Craig. This is the fabulous Craig Ketter. Please.
We haven't done a lot of work together.
No, we haven't. Funny enough, it's one of the first times I've done something collaborative with Craig, and I hope there are many more in the future, because it is wonderful to collaborate with such a wonderful artist where you can meet them and do such dense repertoire, and it's seamless. So he has been absolutely a godsend, and I thank you for Scott for referring him. And this last aria was actually the first Wagnerian aria I encountered and started upon. This is Brangaina's aria, and as you could tell into the program, we ended the Wesen Donk with dreaming and understanding all the power it is to have dream and hope. And especially today, it is nice to have a sense of hope and also a sense of reality. And that's what Brangaina is trying to warn the young lovers as they sleep. So this is Einsam wachend in der Nacht from Tristan und Isolde.
Thank you. My name is Peter Phillips, and I have the honor to serve as the president of the Wagner Society. I welcome you and thank you for attending, and I hope you took half of the joy that I took, particularly from the Wesentochlieder, which was, I think, superbly done. Absolutely beautiful, wonderful performance. There are actually, though, three artists that I would like to acknowledge this afternoon, in addition to the two wonderful performers. This recital marks the last time that Scott Carlton will be assisting the Wagner Society in its annual recitals. He also has been instrumental in identifying, along with some colleagues, the recipients of the Lauck and Springer grants and awards for many, many years. And Scott is an accomplished vocalist, an accomplished pianist, a sought-after coach and teacher. He was a member of the New York Opera Chorus for many years, and the Metropolitan Opera Chorus for many years, the Bayreuth Chorus for many years. And the idea that he agreed over a series of years to share his gifts with us renders his contribution irreplaceable. I don't want the sun to go down today without publicly acknowledging his gifts and his kindness, and I ask you to join me. Scott.
Thank you. I was not really prepared to say anything, but I'm very inspired by this afternoon's performance. It's been a very great privilege for me to be associated with the artists, the young artists, the people who managed to make it to the bottom rung of the industry, and the few that managed to climb a little higher. It's been so inspiring to me to accompany them on their journey. And I always say that the day that artificial intelligence can do what Stanley did with the Wesentochlieder, that's when I'm really going to throw in the towel and say it's all over for humanity. So thank you very much, Peter, for your kind words.
Thank you.
It's been a great pleasure. Thank you.